Hello everybody, my name is Sviatoslav and welcome to Luxury Benefits channel. And today we will talk what is stress and how to overcome it. What is stress? Stress is a problem of our time. Everyone knows cases when people in stressful situation lifted huge weights for a fraction of a second, liquidated accidents, treating deaths, climbed a mountain or jumped over an abyss, everything in order to save themselves and loved ones. Under the influence of a strong irritant, adrenaline thrown into the blood, the heart began to beat faster, the pressure rises, the brain became with better oxygen supply, increased speed and clarity of thinking muscle stands in anticipation of the command and as a result an instant reaction. However, if the body is constantly on alert, instead of benefits, stress starts to be harmful. World Health Organization calls occupational stress a disease of the 21st century because this type of stress occurs in any professions of the world and took on the dimensions of a global epidemic. Such a terrifying growth, professional stress is triggered by a variety of factors, some of which is technical progress. A strong stressful agent for the modern person is the development of communication systems. In general, there are several types of stress depending on the cause of its occurrence. Intrapersonal unfulfilled dream, some needs, interpersonal difficulty in communicating with others, the presence of conflicts of threats of the occurrence, personal inconsistency with a social role, emotional associated with emotional response to various situation, professional stress of businessmen, managers, white collars, environmental associated with the impact of adverse environmental factors. There are other classification, this is just a few of the possible. It's generally believed that only negative emotions and situations cause stress. But no, stress can be obtained after a long or bright holiday, after winning a lottery. Also, of course, more often stress occurs under the influence of factors with a sign minus. However, nervous and physical stress causes any excessive unusual stimuli, and there is no difference for the body whether these are positive emotions or negative. The main thing is that they are strong, redundant, don't give a person a break. At a medicine, about stress is spoken of in cases where events occurring in a person's life suppress his ability to deal with situation. A strong shock causes the release of adrenaline into the blood, and then another portion, and another and more, and then exhaustion. At first, a decrease in attention, memory, is usually absent-mindedness, irritability due to dissatisfaction with oneself and others, sleep disturbances, difficulty falling asleep, nightmares, then apathy, and unwillingness to do anything, depression. Under stress, a person becomes restless, irritable, tired, constantly is in tension. He wants to sleep all the time, or he is not able to sleep at all. He can have an insatiable appetite and gains weight, or the food is not at all attractive and he is losing weight. He may even develop somatic symptoms such as headache, joint and muscle pain, blurred vision, skin rashes, gastritis or other disorders of the digestive system. stress push the body on, but impossible always be excited. Excitation is followed by inhibition of all functions, apathy and depression begins. Whatever the stress, good or bad, emotional or physical, or both at the same time, its effect on the body has common features, especially from the immune systems, suffers from the stress. Stressed people are more likely can get infection, since the numbers of immune cells falls noticeably during the period of physical or mental stress. In response to stress, a healthy person always experiences anxiety and confusion. This state is an automatic preparation for an active action, the attacker or protective. This preparation is always carried out in the body, even when no physical action is required. The same happens when there is no real danger. However, prolonged excitement, even positive, leads to one result – exhaustion. Exhaustion can cause passivity, a state of helplessness, hopelessness, depression, apathy. Apathy is the body's last attempt to escape from escalation. The so-called psychosomatic diseases or conditions associated with a decrease in immunity. If a person ignores this signal, continuing to drive yourself in a corner, a series of diseases comes. However, the most unfavorable is a chronic stressful situation. Exactly then there is exhaustion and the threat of disease development. How do you recognize when stress is becoming a chronic? In stuck certain symptoms, disorders in the psycho-emotional sphere. These are either irritation reactions, aggressiveness, irritability, anger or exhaustion reactions, apathy, depression, passivity, neuropsychiatric disorders, panic attacks, sudden, unreasonable, intense fear, often accompanied by fear of going insane, fear of death, tachycardia, shortness of breath, and dizziness. Or a social phobia, expressed fear of being in the spotlight or fear of behaving in a way that will cause embarrassment or humiliation. Other phobias, fear of animals, birds, insects, darkness, confined spaces, dentists, heights, flights, etc. There is also generalized anxiety disorder, persistence, pronounced feeling tension, anxiety and upcoming troubles in everyday events, and problems for several months. Frequent symptoms, excessive stress of muscles, irritability, sleep problems, and chronic fatigue. There are also adjustment disorders, post-traumatic stress disorder, obsessive-compulsive disorder, other anxiety disorders. Quite common consequences of excessive stress: dystonia, sleep disturbances, insomnia, superficial sleep, nightmares, daytime sleepiness, neurocirculatory dystonia, somatoform autonomic dysfunction, disorders of sexual desire, serious or prolonged psycho-emotional stress. In some cases, leads to the development of diseases and neuroses. Therefore, chronic stress required medical treatment. The problem here may be arise in the fact that the manifestation of stress will be treated, but if its cause is not eliminated, then there will be no effect. common methods for dealing with stress. Stress is a such state that you cannot write one prescription for everybody to overcome. What will help one, the other will be absolutely useless. But there are some fairly general options for dealing with stress. Firstly, this is a technique aimed directly at eliminating the causes of stress. That it's supposed to change either the situation that causes stress or a person's attitude to this situation. In this case, you need to know exactly the cause of the stress, otherwise all efforts will be not as effective. Secondly, there are so-called quick methods that are capable of ease the current situation. It is necessary to reduce the level of already occurring stressful reactions and strive to avoid amplifying them. This applies if it's impossible to eliminate the cause of the stress. Walking, reading, playing music, sports, workouts, active games are suitable here, or just messing around. Third, active protection against stress. Need to find something to keep the soul balanced that promotes better health. Sports, music, gardening, exercising, etc. This is called active relaxation. Relaxation, which increases the adaptive capabilities of the human organism, both mental and physical. And one more thing to remember, there is no life without stress. Any healthy person, to feel alive and fulfilled, you need to feel the presence of certain problems, which need to be addressed as they appear. In a professional physiologist language, stress is an attempt by the body to independently deal with external aggression. But if the level of stress increases to the threshold when a person can no longer able to adapt, if the dose of stress is too high, useful stress, EU stress, turns into dangerous stress, distress. And when the dose of stress is exceeded too much, then not only the human psyche suffers, but also his somatics, different organs and organism systems. Thanks for watching this video to the end. Today we learned what is stress, symptoms of stress, and the most common methods to overcome it. I hope it will help you. Subscribe to my channel and we'll see you again.